Hello and welcome students in class Heart 211. Today I would like to discuss morphological characteristics of brinjal. There are so many parameters which are discussed here to study the morphological characteristics of brinjal. A brief introduction is: the growth and development of brinjal comprises several sequential changes from germination to maturity. Knowledge of plant structure and growth and development is essential to improve management practices and yield. Generally, morphological characteristics studied right from seed to fruit. It includes all the parts of the plants which should be clearly discussed and studied to know the plant's behavior. By that way we can manage the plants. So morphological characteristics of particular plant should be studied clearly. First plant, the brinjal is a much branched perennial, usually grown as an annual under cultivation. It is characterized by a bush, intermediate erect plant attaining a height of 0.5 to 1.5 meter, and some plants develop spines. The leaves are large and alternate on the stem and are more or less oval in shape. Stems are erect and branching and covered with fine gray hairs. Brinjal has a strong taproot penetrating to a depth of about 1 meter within 6 to 7 weeks. The mature plant has an extensive root system. Germination. The brinjal seed is covered by a leathery seed coat. It is used for sowing purposes. The generally brinjal seeds first raised in nursery, and then after development of the nursery seedlings in the nursery, it should be lifted and finally planted in the field. Germination involves mobilization and utilization of food and energy reserves. The environmental factors which affect germination are soil moisture, temperature, and oxygen supply. A moisture content of about 60% is required for germination of brinjal seed. Brinjal fails to germinate if the soil moisture tension exceeds 7 atmosphere. The optimum germination temperature is around 30 to 35 degrees centigrade. Brinjal germination is epigeal, and under favorable conditions, seedlings emerge in 5 to 6 days after sowing. Root study. Roots are important growth components because they anchor the plant and supply water and mineral nutrients. The brinjal root system is characterized by a tap root that consists of lateral roots arising from the upper portion of the primary root. During the period before true leaves begin expansion, the primary root is penetrating into the soil and branch of roots are being formed. The brinjal root system continues to grow throughout the life cycle of the plant, but the rate of root proliferation is more rapid during early flowering stages. The major portion of the roots is concentrated in the top 30 cm of the soil profile, but brinjal roots have been observed as deep as 1 to 1.5 meter below the soil surface under field conditions. The rate at which root system grow downward depends on the soil fertility status and moisture availability. Now the third one is shoot. The main stem of the brinjal is monopodial with leaves and branches but no flowers. There are usually two axillary buds at each main stem node. Normally only one bud develops out of it. At lower nodes, the first bud remains vegetative and may develop into a vegetative branch of monopodium. Usually the vegetative branch occurs in a definite zone near the base of the plant, and the fruiting branches occurs further up the stem. The number of nodes from the base of the main stalk to the first fruiting branches varies among the brinjal cultivars and is affected by cultural practices. Vegetative shoot growth ceases at about the last fruit picking. Now we discuss about leaves. The leaves are usually large lobed, ovate, thin, and relatively hairy on the undersurface. The leaves occasionally bear sharp spines. Its surface contains many stomata through which gases are exchanged between plant and the atmosphere. Most of the stomata are on the underside of the leaf. The petiole is about 1/4 as long as the leaflet. At the point where it joins the stem, our branch is enlarged. Now we discuss about flowers. The flowers are large, violet colored, solitary, or form cluster of two or more borne in lateral cymes, having a deeply lobed and toothed calyx bearing a few prickles and a rotate purplish corolla. On most varieties, flowers are borne singly and opposite of leaves. The pedicel is erect, thick, and up to 6 cm long. The large fleshy calyx is persistent, usually 5-lobed, enlarging and enclosing the base of the fruit. The expanded purple corolla is bright in appearance, about 5 cm in diameter, having 5 partite lobes. The anthers are yellowish, arranged in a cone around the style, and is discharged the pollen longitudinally through terminal pores. The style is simple, yellowish, and the stigma is capitate. The stigma often projects beyond the anthers. Following pollination, the fruit is a berry is formed. Now we discuss about pollination behavior of brinjal. Self-pollination is more common than cross-pollination in brinjal. The cone-like shape of anthers favors self-pollination, but since stigma ultimately projects behind the anthers, there is a simple opportunity for cross-pollination. The extent of cross-pollination in brinjal may vary from 0.2 to 46.8%, averaging about 6.7%. Now we discuss about fruits. The brinjal fruit is a fleshy berry and forms in a pendant position. It is held by the calyx, which after the corolla has withered, enlarges considerably, enclosing the entire basal portion of the mature fruit. The fruit is usually borne singly at the nodes. The fruits are large, up to 500 grams, and may extremely variable in shape, oval to oblong, and color, purple, purple black, white, green, and red. The ripe fruits are usually pale to bright yellow in color. The seeds are scattered through the fruit, embedded in a firm placenta. Many seeds are formed in a single fruit, 800 to 1000 in long brinjal and 1000 to 1500 in round brinjal. The seeds are small, about 2 to 3 millimeter in diameter, flattened, pale brown, kidney shaped with leathery seed coat. Now we discuss about taxonomy of brinjal. The brinjal belongs to the family Solanaceae, or it is also known as Nilaceae family. The cultivated species of brinjal Solanum melongena yell differ in shape and color of fruits. The fruit is a large, smooth, glossy, firm, fleshed, pendant berry up to 15 cm long, usually oblong or somewhat pear-shaped, ovoid or obovoid, ranging from white or yellow to deep purple or black, or even stipped with a shining surface. There are only three main botanical varieties under Solanum melongena. The round or egg-shaped cultivars are grouped under variety Esculentum. The long, slender types are included under variety Serpentinum. The dwarf brinjal plants are grouped under variety Depression. Other species of Solanum are as follows: Solanum aculeateatum, Solanum nodiflorum, Solanum ethiopicum, Solanum acranthum, Solanum americanax, Solanum patinatum, Solanum anguivi, and Solanum pseudocapsicum, and so on. Besides, the following wild species of Solanum genus have been recognized and studied in varietal development of brinjal. Generally, these are used to incorporate the disease resistant or insect resistant in the cultivated varieties. So there is a very, very important role of the wild varieties in breeding programs. And these are Solanum gylo, Solanum macrocarpon, Solanum incanum, solanum nigrum, solanum indicum, solanum sesamifolium, solanum integrifolium and solanum tarbum. Students are advised to read about these wild species of brinjal so that they may be well versed in these species. Growth stages, there are certain stages, these are generally discussed, how much time is required for particular stage, that is seedling stage. Brinjal is a tender perennial grown as annual. It is raised in nursery beds and seedling age of transplantation is 40 to 45 days. Vegetative stage. Vegetative development starts from 20 days after sowing and ends with the start of flowering, that is from 45 to 50 days after transplanting. The vegetative growth supports the photosynthetic capacity of the plant, which supports the yield. During vegetative growth, roots, leaves and stems may compete for photosynthetic products. The partitioning of products may be controlled by plant hormones or by environmental factors. If there is water stress, plant shoots are affected more than roots. Flowering stage. Initiation of flowering varies with cultivar and environmental factors. Flowering may be visible at 65 to 70 days or may be delayed until 80 days when certain genotypes or environments interact. Flowering may occur over a period of 6 to 10 weeks after start of flowering, depending on the environment and cultivar. Fruiting and maturity. Fruits are normally visible about 2 weeks after the start of flowering. After fertilization of the flower, the fruits develop slowly for the first few days, then the rate of development increases until the fruit reaches maximum size. The number of fruits varies from 15 to 35 in a single plant. At maturity, fruit may contain 800 to 1500 seeds approximately. The 1000 seed weight is approximately 5 grams. A chronology of phenological development of brinjal plant is presented here. Phenological phase, duration in days. Seed germination, it takes 4 to 7 days. Seedling, 40 to 45 days. Vegetative stage, 45 to 75. Flowering, 75 to 100. Fruiting and maturity, 100 to 150 days. The sequences of events remain the same regardless of cultivar or environmental condition, but the absolute times between events may vary by several days as a function of cultivar and environment. Thank you.